Hello, I'm Fran Scott, and I've got a little bit of a strange job, it's got to be said. I am a science demonstration developer, which basically means that I design science demonstrations. So people come to me, be it from TV or radio, or people that are doing science books, and they want a science demonstration that'll show a certain scientific idea. And then it's up to me to design that demonstration. And I got into this job. I do absolutely love it. I got into it by doing all the sciences at A-level. So I did chemistry, physics, biology, and maths. And then from my A-levels, I went on to study at the University of Nottingham, where I did an undergraduate master's in neuroscience. Now, an undergraduate master's is basically a master's of science of industry, where you do 3 years lectures and 1 year in the field. Now, this 1 year could be done at a drugs company, but that wasn't really the direction I wanted to go in. So I did my year in industry. I actually got selected to go to the University of Melbourne, and I studied stem cells over there. Now, having stared down a microscope for 12, 13 hours a day in the dark, counting different neurons and glial cells, I realized that wasn't quite where I thought I could go. And so in my final year of university, I realized that science communication was the route I wanted to take. And so I went to the Science Museum, was where I started my career. And slowly, over those long 7 years, I built up a reputation for myself. And now I'm a freelance science demonstration developer, and I love it. Now, the reason I studied science was, I don't know, I think I was just built a scientist from a very young age. I'm just extremely curious, and I just always wanted to know how things worked, and usually that involved just destroying them and taking them apart and then learning how to put them back together again, and that's basically what I do for my job now. But I just loved asking questions. It sounds cheesy, but asking questions about the world around me and just finding out things that I didn't know. I just absolutely loved it, and I decided I was good at science. I found it easy, to be honest with you, and so I went and did all the sciences, and I'm really quite glad I did. The person that probably inspired me the most, a lot of people say it was their teacher or their lecturer. Now, I didn't go to a very good school, so my teachers were lovely, but there's not particularly one that inspired me in a way. And I would say my biggest inspiration has to be my mum and dad. They were just excellent parents. When we had a question about why something did what it did, they didn't give us the answer. They would say, go and look it up, find out. Try poking it, see what happens. Try burning it, see what happens. And that's what's made me increase my curiosity as I've got older. I've never lost that youthful curiosity. And I've got my parents to thank for that. If you ask anyone to draw their stereotypical scientist, odds on it would be a white, middle-aged, middle-class or upper-class man. And there are a lot of scientists like that. So why is it that there aren't people from other backgrounds, other sexes, you know, encouraged into science, doing science? Well, personally, I think it's a two-way problem. At my school, definitely, especially when I was doing A-level, the girls were underrepresented in all the sciences apart from biology. There was a fair balance of boys to girls in biology. And it's half to do with them looking and finding role models that are like them. But a lot of it, for me personally, was having the courage to be different. And it was because of my parents that I had that courage to be different. But, you know, there is pressure from the outside world for you to, you know, go a certain way and be a certain type of person. But it works both ways. You know, just the fact that there's no one like you doing that doesn't mean you can't be that person doing that. So yes, the world needs to change slightly and perhaps not be so singular in its view of who can be a scientist. But at the same time, perhaps we need to stop being so singular in our view and believe that we can do anything as well. So I got involved with the Science Girl calendar, and all because of a lovely woman named Heather Williams. as the calendar was born basically from frustration, but sort of positive frustration from the launch of the Science It's a Girl Thing video. And a lot of people just really wanted to act on that video in a less stereotypical way, and that was where the calendar was born from. And Heather, through the medium of Twitter, basically just got everyone fired up about it. And I ended up in rather comical shoot, actually, which is here, which was somehow, I don't know, I ended up with all the Tomorrow's World presenters, which was brilliant fun. And these are people that I used to see on TV and inspired me to, although I wasn't, you know, a middle-aged white man, to get into science and still, you know, go to the cinema, still have friends that weren't into science, but still be intrigued about science. And these are the people that inspired me to keep going with that. So I was really privileged to be part of this photo. And it's sort of, it was done at Ali Pali, Alexandra Palace, where the old BBC studios used to be. And it was sort of like a retro style shoot. And as you can tell by his cameras, and it was just phenomenal to be there. It was a museum in itself. And it was a very good day. Now, I've been asked to pick a scientist or a female scientist that inspired me and that I can not strive to be like, but that just gives a fire in my belly. And I'm not actually going to pick a woman. The person I'm going to pick, it's a little bit cheesy, but I'm going to pick Michael Faraday. And I just love the way that he broke down stereotypes. You know, he's not actually, some people don't even consider him to be a scientist, which just shows you it's a crazy world out there. He was the best scientist I can think of, and he wasn't privileged. He was just so driven. He was a bookbinder. He jumped on every opportunity that wasn't given to him, that he made for himself. And he became a role model to millions of people. And he not only did incredible science, but he communicated this science in such a way that it got the public fired up about this subject. And I just think he was an amazing man.